But first, a man has been charged over the stabbing death of a teenager at a railway station in Sydney's west.
10 crime reporter Matt Doran joins us now from the scene at Bankstown. Matt, it was a fight between a few young men that police allege ended in murder.
Deb, a murder that played out right in front of peak hour commuters here at Bankstown Railway Station a little under 24 hours ago. Deb, we can reveal that the alleged murderer is a man named Mossa Julius Mabelli. He is a 22-year-old of African background. Now, he was also injured during this attack. He was rushed to hospital with stab wounds to the head and to the chest. And it was there a short time ago that he was charged with murder at a bedside hearing, and he remains there under guard. Now, the victim's family is, of course, crushed by this incident, but they are hoping that some good may come from the grief. The teenage boy's distraught father has pleaded for an end to teenage violence, more particularly gang-related crime.
All who knew him say he'll be remembered for a clumsy sense of humour and an enviable thirst for life. Last night, that life was snatched away on the platform of Bankstown Railway Station. 16-year-old Brandon Aliasiata CR was stabbed during peak hour. His body then kicked onto the tracks. Paramedics worked furiously for 20 minutes but couldn't revive him. Brandon's family gathered today at Sydney Airport to collect the boy's mother, who returned from holiday in Samoa unaware her son had died. His father has pleaded for an end to teenage violence.
Hopefully my son passed away so the youths can learn from that and what happened now for the future. It's not like just close your eye and come back tomorrow. This is the end of your life, and that's why your life is very special.
The alleged murderer, a 22-year-old of African background, was rushed to hospital with stab wounds to his head and chest. A 15-year-old boy was also stabbed but will recover. Several young men were arrested.
He left home carrying a knife. And that's not the actions of a responsible, prudent member of our community.
Brandon is the third young person killed near the station in the past decade.
Even among Brandon's closest friends, it's unclear precisely what triggered this dispute. They admit he was a dedicated member of a local gang and would proudly defend his colours, but they strongly deny he was prone to violence.
These boys from this gang made comments about his sister, and Brandon didn't take that lightly because he's a family kid, you know. He sticks up for his family, he reps his family.
He was a funny bloke, no doubt about it, man. Very caring, humble, you know, never looked for trouble.
Hundreds gathered at the station late today for an hour-long vigil. Some scrawled tributes on the platform where he lost his life. Others were simply too crushed by the grief.
Well, Matt, this has again raised concerns that gang activity in Sydney's west is out of control.
Bill, it absolutely has. And look, it is the family's one great hope that some lessons will emerge from this tragedy. It has thrown the spotlight well and truly on youth services right through this Bankstown area. In fact, some social workers have said that this death may even have been prevented had there been better funding.
Bored teenagers, youths with nowhere else to go, spending their nights on the street. It's a combination that's proven fatal all too often. Brawls in Mount Druitt. In 2008, Andrew Motoliki was stabbed to death on a train at Campsie. And now this, bloodshed at Bankstown. In the hours before the stabbing last night, many of Brendan CS's friends were here at Homebase, a youth centre for teens in Bankstown.
We do overcome those cultural barriers here, and, you know, it's awesome to see it.
But funding cuts have meant the centre will close its doors next Tuesday, right when they were hoping to extend its hours of operation.
So kids just really feel that they don't belong. Like, they sit somewhere, they're told to, you know, can't sit here, you've got to move on, then they're told to move on again. These messages go into the young people saying we're not wanted.
It's now one question that will haunt everyone in the local community, particularly those social workers. What if the centre had stayed open just 1 hour longer? Could this death have been prevented?
If it was open longer, you know, we would have all been inside and engaging in positive activity.
They hope a fundraising night at the end of June will allow the centre to reopen. New premises have been found closer to the station, but the fit-out could take months and cost thousands of dollars, leaving kids on their own.
You feel gutted that, you know, you weren't able to prevent it. Like, so, It's hard. You think about the boy, you think about his family, you think about the kids who saw it. Like, kids shouldn't go through that stuff.
Evan Batten, 10 News.